I feel like there's less comedy movies these days. Would you agree with that?
No. I think there are less movies, period, these days.
Okay. Is it a lot of, like, there's a lot of almost comic book type movies and universes that are those are the movies now.
Yeah.
Does that feel weird to you? Because, or not weird to you, or like, what are your thoughts on that? That it's like, I don't know if one like has eliminated the other, but it's just kind of like, why is that? Why do we see these big, huge things, but it feels tougher for somebody to create just like a good comedy these days?
I think good comedy went to TV and to streaming because they needed to fill coffers quick, you know, fill programming schedules quick. So,
or like, did the Marvel universes and all the comic book universes, did they kill off?
No.
Like this, the 100%, guy?
100% no. The studios like to make money. Right. They're in the business to make money. I don't think a comic book movie has made them go like, let's give up on the mid-range. They're just like, look, more risk, more reward. And then when I first started, there was television, there was movies. Now there are many more options and many more places to go. So instead of doing, you know, and you'll see it like an six or eight episode show where you're like, could have been done in three. It's because like a lot of people are like, all right, I'm going to take my idea that was for a feature and stretch it out into a show. So I think, you know, never mind comedy, I'd be more curious, hey, where'd the indie film go?
Yeah.
But I think the indie film was taken over by Netflix. Once Netflix came in, number one, they started buying cheap movies. And number two, they started making programming that was kind of interesting. They went to other countries and they were like, who are your top filmmakers? Here's money, go make TV shows and stuff. And that's where all the interesting ideas are going and finding a home. You're somebody who wants to tell an offbeat story and you're looking at this Sisyphean task of like, I gotta roll this fucking boulder up the hill. Like every time I make a movie, it's like, fuck, here we go. It's gonna be fucking tough. Or you walk into these cats and they're like, what's it about? How esoteric is it? Interesting. Go ahead. Can you make it six episodes? Can you make it eight? That's preferable. And that's where all the interesting programming has slowly gravitated to now.
So you're saying some of the indie movies have actually become television shows.
I think indie filmmakers or people that make things off the beaten path stories that don't necessarily fall into the big budget equation have wound up going to streaming. Like, you know, what was fucking Jason Bateman's show, Ozark?
Yeah.
It's an indie film. This just happens to be a series that went on for a bunch of episodes because they're like, hey, we like it. Do it again. Instead of getting a sequel, you just get another season.
That's a good point. It's like, it was almost like there's a secret gay guy at the lake. It was like people playing gay Clue at the lake, remember? Because like that one guy ended
up. In Ozark?
Yeah.
I didn't watch the whole show.
And,
I was just using it as an example.
It started to get redundant. Like it started to get. But now
for some reason, I really want to play gay Clue. Does that exist? Yeah.
No, they should have that, right?
Right.
Like he did it in, yeah, it was, it was like.
What do you use the candlestick for? They're like, find out.
Samuel's been in the billiard room for a while.
in the conservatory, not being very conservative.
Wow, I've never used that to cue my pool stick before. what's that thing called? To pool chalk?
I've never chalked that way.
Yeah. So that's interesting. So
I think that's part of it. Believe me, I'm not like, and that's exactly what happened. And
no, it's cool. I think
that's part of it. I think, you know, Netflix came in, disrupted the business, as we all know, in a way that at first people were like, yeah. And now people are like, wait a second. In the aftermath, nothing existed the way that existed before. Television viewership is like down to almost nothing, so much so that major studios are writing off entire network divisions and stuff like that, devaluing television in order to get a write-off. So once Netflix came in and said, hey, this is how we're doing it, and then every other company was like, well, shit, we got to do what they're doing, and they started doing streaming and whatnot, it just really, it broke the model. It's kind of nuts. So right now, I think if you're a person that likes to tell off-the-beaten-path stories, or if what we used to call back in the day an indie filmmaker, now's the time to shine. I think there's a moment that's going on right now where entertainment, like the way people are getting their entertainment, of course, has completely changed over the last 10 years, but theatrical consumption has been way off since COVID. And some people wonder if like, will people ever go back to movies the way they used to and blah, blah, blah. They're not going to go unless you give them something they can't get anyplace else. Mm. So they'll go to the theaters to see Deadpool Wolverine because like, I ain't going to be able to watch this at home for like 6 months, so fuck it. But what if you tell them a story, going back to your voice as your currency, they've never heard before, and the only place they could see it is in a theater. And right now theaters are hurting, so they'll fucking take anybody. It doesn't matter. It used to be tough to get screens. Now, are you fucking kidding me? You can make a deal with AMC, a private deal with your own independent movie where you're like, Can I get 100 screens and we'll do a door split or whatever the fuck? It's possible because movie theaters, as a movie theater exhibitor, I know this for a fact, we would kill or die to have people come in. You know, back in the day, I made this movie, the 4:30 movie, mm-hmm. and it's about how in
this
the
is, 80s- This is your new film.
This is the new film that's coming out September 13th. In the 80s, we used to pay for one movie and then jump from theater to theater to theater to go movies for free. I own that movie theater that I used to do that in. We get caught and you might get the risk of being banned from that theater for fucking life. If I caught you walking into another movie theater after you paid for only one movie theater, my movie theater, I'd be like, that's great. Just buy some popcorn, would you? You could stay as long as you fucking want. Call your friends.
Yeah.
Have them come just to get fucking bodies through the goddamn door. Imagine you're an indie filmmaker who wants to say the thing nobody has ever fucking said before. In a film, per se. We're just using film as an example. Fuck, now is your time. Like, you could actually make a thing and have it be in a goddamn movie theater. And then if you do even the tiniest bit of business with your movie in a movie theater these days, that's a fucking story.
Yeah.
And that also has, it's been proven, like, through the algorithm, when Amazon did Air, Ben Affleck's movie Air, they put it in theaters and they spent-
A-I-R.
A-I-R, about Air Jordans, the history of the Air Jordan sneaker. They put it in theaters traditionally and spent money on advertising, even though Amazon has Prime and really they probably thought it would go right there, but they were like, you know what? Let's see what it would be like to release a movie. Like, you know, Amazon and other streamers broke the theatrical model and here they're going like, wouldn't it be novel? Like us with Smodcast going like, wouldn't it be weird if somebody paid for an ad on our show? These cats are like, wouldn't it be novel if we put the movie out and paid for ads and people saw a trailer and then went to the movies to see it, would it make it more valuable when we then put it on Prime?
Mm.
And it did, naturally. They found the same thing out on Netflix. Movies that go the traditional route, the way that everybody expects. I've seen a commercial for that on TV. That will be a primary choice on Netflix rather than a Netflix made for Netflix movie that may have the biggest fucking stars on the planet on it in it. But you will pass it by.
Yeah, it feels so. There's something about just watching a movie that's just on Netflix or on a street.
Isn't that crazy?
Yeah,
but there is a value to putting something in a theater. Still, it gives it this kind of panache.